Simple trading strategy to make $100 a week in Bitcoin and cryptocurrency. Welcome back, guys. It's Crypto Rocko from Rockstar Trading Channel. In today's video, guys, I'll share step by step my exact trading strategy. First, I'll share with you the rules of the trading strategy. Then we'll go onto the charts, share with you exactly where I'm buying, where I'm selling. I want to share with you the steps and live trading charts, how to buy, how to sell, so you can actually make money. I've had lots of requests since my post of the Bitcoin trade on Twitter, and I made a detailed YouTube video as well. So I want to make a video share with you exactly my trading strategy, when to buy, when to sell. Also, guys, I'll share with you proofs as well. Lots of people say, are you actually buying? Are you actually selling? So I'll share with you my trade setups as well. You know, in the YouTube videos, I show exactly when I'm buying, when I'm selling. In the Rockstar Trading Group, guys, I can post exactly when I'm entering. In the YouTube videos, I'll make it, like in this video, I'll share with you where I'm looking to buy, where I'm looking to sell. In the Rockstar Trading Group, I can post exactly where I'm entering, where I'm buying, trading courses, live streams, Telegram group, all that good stuff. If you are interested, guys, I'll leave the links below and I'll explain at the end of the video. Now let's get into the strategy. So the first, I'll share with you the simple steps to look for. The very first thing is a daily moving average. So what we look for in the daily moving average is Bitcoin above or below the daily 20 moving average? As long as Bitcoin is above the daily 20 moving average, we are bullish. When it's below the daily 20 moving average, we're bearish. If we study this bull market since, you know, October last year, once we got back above the daily moving average, Bitcoin has been really aggressively going up. It has had pullbacks to the daily moving average, but it got bought up quickly until May 2021 when we had that sell-off, and we've been struggling to get back above it. So that's the, again, this is a very simple trading strategy for new people. I've explained to you the first rule. Please, as with all the rules that I share, go back onto your charts. This is the TradingView, the platform that I use. I'll leave the links below of you can get a discount to join TradingView. You can have a free account as well. You don't have to spend money if you're completely new. But get on TradingView and practice, see if the strategy works. This was back in February. You can see when we got back above the daily moving average, that's when we had the move up, and below the daily moving average, we sold off. That's the first thing I want to share with you guys. So that's the first step of the rule. Second step is using RSI on the hourly time frame, and when it's oversold and ticking above, you look to buy. When it's overbought and ticking below, you look to sell. So when you know that it's above the daily moving average, I'll share with you a couple of exact trades setups, but when you know the Bitcoin is above the daily moving average, you go onto the hourly. Usually RSI setting is 14, and most people use RSI wrong. There's, you know, an hour long video explaining to you my exact how I trade RSI. So you change it to 5, and then you click, and then you go onto the hourly time frame, and when Bitcoin is above the daily moving average, you look to buy. When it's oversold and ticking back above, so it's oversold now, ticking back above, it's gone up. Oversold, ticking back above, it's gone up. You can also ask me, you know, it's almost oversold, would you buy here? Yes, you would. And, you know, I'll share with you the entry stop loss targets, but let me share with you the rules first. So these are the first two simple rules that I want you to write down, and before going on this video, pause this video, go practice, or write these rules down so you can practice before. I know you want to watch the video till the end, and I highly recommend watch the video a few times, and, you know, you can ask me questions. I'm doing a free live stream on YouTube tomorrow 7 p.m. or you can join the group and ask me questions. But first of all, please practice. Anyone can watch this video, but practicing and educating yourself and making money is a completely different thing. You know, making prediction, anyone can make prediction, but as you've seen in my YouTube channel, I actually make calls when I buy, when I sell, beforehand, and release it on videos. And that's a really difficult thing to do, and it takes years of practice. Some people can learn it in a few months, but usually it takes longer. And then the next thing we look for is support and resistance. What we look for is buying near support, and, you know, what the other thing we do is sell near resistance. So, you know, if the trade setup I shared, we look to buy near support. So the trade setup on this one, it was bouncing from support. Go watch the charts where we were. You know, this was the Twitter video I made exactly explaining, you know, it was bouncing from support. This trade I shared, you know, buying from 32k, this was near support. So what we try to do is Bitcoin, we buy near support, sell near resistance. Now it's near resistance. If it starts breaking down, we would look to sell. So that's the third rule. Look to buy near support and sell near resistance. You could just follow the markets and use the first two rules, and you probably overall, if you can stick to it, you can make money. But the more you add to this strategy, the refined it gets. This is just an overview, a simple way of looking at the market. I look at support, resistance, trend, and lots of other things, but I'm sharing with you four simple rules that you can add to your game and start building your own trading system. And then the next thing I look for is whether it's in an uptrend or downtrend. There's lots of videos on my channel explaining uptrend, downtrends. On my course, there's 20 hour long videos explaining this step by step. But in to give you an overall, this is how I see the market. Successive rallies, penetrating preceding high points with ensuing declining, terminating above preceding low points, offer a bullish indication. So higher high, higher low, higher high, higher low above. And as long as A is below, is above B, we say it is in an uptrend. In a live chart, higher high, higher low, higher high, that is in an uptrend. Downtrend is completely the opposite, in a lower low, lower high, lower low. So if you see in an uptrend, if you're buying in an uptrend, your probability of making money is higher than if you buy in a downtrend. So, you know, in an uptrend, the probabilities of long is higher. In a downtrend, the probability of short is higher. You know, if it's at support, buying is the probability is higher. You know, it's, if it's at resistance, selling is higher. So at the moment where Bitcoin is, if we just draw support and resistance, if you ask me whether I'm looking to buy or sell, you can check on my charts. I posted about taking profit at least 75%, and Bitcoin was around 38, 39K at that time. We look to take profit or short around resistance, and we look to buy. So the trade setup that I shared, this was around the 30K mark. This is when we look to buy, and when it comes into here, we look to sell. So again, write this down. The probability of winning trades are higher if you're buying at support, and write this down. Probability of sales or shorting is higher when Bitcoin is at resistance. And these are the four main rules I want to share with you. And if you can master these four rules, you can add an indicator like RSI, you can add any other indicators you want, but it can really help you in this system. If you practice it over time, you can ask me questions, you can build it. Everyone has a different trading psychology. And, you know, I'll talk about risk management and psychology. I'll give you four or five tips at the end of the video to improve and actually make money. I don't want this to be another video where you learn a strategy, but you don't apply. I want you guys to actually learn this strategy, apply it. And, you know, I want success stories. We've had some amazing success stories in the group and people watching my YouTube video, you know, getting in link early, theta early, and, you know, making, you know, life-changing money, you know, paying off mortgage and all that good stuff. I want you guys to actually use this information. So I'll give you guys four tips at the end of the video. Now let's share with you a couple of examples. So the first example I want to share is this. And again, watch this video and exact trade setup. You know, you can, I posted exactly when I entered in the Telegram group, but this is the proof of, you know, me buying and selling. And it was all explained in this video with my exact plan before I actually got in. This was, you know, posted on the 23rd of July, where I was looking to buy above there. And you can see 23rd of July was here. This was when it was breaking out here. So from here to there was my trade from, you can see there, 33 to 37, 38. That was my main trade. So let's explain to you that trade. So what happened, I'll draw this. So first thing I said is above the daily moving average, and Bitcoin was getting back above the daily moving average here. Let me go on to another chart of it. I've put some rules in there already for you to explain. So we can see Bitcoin is above the daily moving averages here. So let's go on to the hourly time frame. We know Bitcoin is above the daily moving average. Now we can look for oversold RSI. So oversold RSI is here. So you can look to buy it here. And then stop loss, I want to put your stop loss below the second support. So if we look to buy it here, because it's oversold, and I don't want to just pick the best examples, I'll pick any example, because if I pick this is a better buy and it just goes up, but trading doesn't work like that. And stop loss, I want you to put your stop loss below two supports, so you can go onto the 4 hourly time frame and find the support, or on the hourly time frame, again, I want to keep it simple, on the hourly time frame, have your stop loss below two supports. So this is first support, this is second support, so you have your stop loss below there. And then target first resistance. Usually you should target first resistance, and then if you target first resistance, you get a one-to-one trade. And, you know, whenever you enter, always try to get take half off or take some profits at one-to-one. For me, the way I try, I want you guys to use these setups to read the markets, because usually you don't have any guideline with when to buy, when to be bullish, when to be bearish, when to sell. So these four guidelines, I want you to understand how everyone else thinks and give you a structure, because most people trade with emotions. Most people are probably buying now, FOMOing in, but we want to be buying here. So my trade setup, I actually just bought it because I wasn't at my desk there. I saw Bitcoin here and I said, look, Bitcoin is bullish. If it breaks below here, I'll get stopped out. And I'm sure I put the risk on here as well. I said, as long as, you know, as long as it holds above, you know, this level, and, you know, it held above 30K and it went up. So that's the entry setup, you know, below two stop level, take half off at 1-to-1 and then try to run it, and you'll probably get more setups. So using the trade strategy, that will be the first trade setup. And then, you know, move your stop loss up as it's going up, and, you know, you could potentially get targets up to there. So let's follow. We still know it's above the daily moving average. We wait for RSI to get oversold again. RSI gets oversold here again. This would be a buy, and it's ticking above. So it ticked above on this candle. So this will be your entry. This is the first support level. Second support level is here. So you'll have your stop loss just below there. Target 1-to-1 first. You know, 1-to-1 is there. And then if it carries on going higher, amazing. I'd actually, you know, potentially have less than 1-to-1. If the risk reward is less than 1-to-1, I don't really want to be taking the trades. We want to be taking trades when the risk reward is at least 1-to-1. And hopefully the secret, again, I'll talk about tips, is in knowing risk management and letting profit run. As you can see, I took half off a lot way before that this trade. I took some off here, and then I managed to let it run and get an amazing profit. Most trades won't be like this, and I know it looks really fancy. That's why most people are asking about the strategy, but that's a very simple strategy you can start using now to start making money. I know it sounds a lot now. Watch the video. So first thing I want you guys to think about is daily 20 moving average, then RSI oversold or overbought. And then two things to help you get the winning trades is buying at support, selling at resistance, and buying in an uptrend, selling in a downtrend. So that was one example that worked really well. We can give you another example. And this one is, and we also mean, this is another tip I can give you. Look to do buy and sell when it's at the daily moving average. You know, when it's far away from the daily moving average, like now, it's a bit difficult. Try to take your trades at the daily moving average. So now we see, you know, the market is breaking down here. And what we look for is to get overbought. It gets overbought here. You know, we below the daily moving average, we look to sell. And it's also another tip is look for the price to be near the hourly 20 moving average. And a lot of the setups I'm sharing, you'll see they are near the hourly moving average. This will give you another really good tip on when to buy and when to sell. If it's too far away from the hourly moving average, don't take trades. But again, I'll give tips. These are things that you practice and decide for yourself. This will be the sell. You know, this is the first resistance. This is the second resistance. So your stop loss will go there, you know, just a bit lower, and then target 1-to-1 first, and then if it works, carry on running. And I, like I said, I don't want to just share with you winners, as I want to talk about losers as well. Around here, the price did get back above, but it did not cleanly break. You know, look at this one. It was a big green candle, broke out. This was, you know, big red candle. It broke down. On here, Bitcoin did try and break out above, and you could have easily, you know, gone for a trade there, and it would not have worked out. So I don't want to just cherry pick winners. That is a trade that would not have worked out. So Bitcoin tried to break out. You would have gone to the hourly, tried to buy. When it got oversold, you know, it did have a nice little bounce, but that would not have made you money. So if you stop loss was there, your target would have been there, you would not have made money. So that in trading, you have winners, you have losers. I don't want to just cherry pick like some people do and share with you only the winners. So those are some examples. I can go through some more examples. You know, there's two more examples here I'll go through, and then I'll start finishing off the video and end with some tips. So these are two videos where you could have got a trade that would have worked out. So Bitcoin breaks above the daily. We look for the RSI to be oversold. Bitcoin gets oversold here. It ticks back above. So this one is a touch and go one. So it shows you the importance of taking profit. So your stop loss there, you get a nice 1-to-1. It wasn't the best trade, but it's still a nice 1-to-1. You can get RSI oversold, ticking above. But if you didn't take profit, it would have. If you didn't take profit there in this spike, you would have completely got blown out. And here, if you look, this is another one. It breaks down below, gives you an hourly setup, and then it sells off. It gives you another one there as well. And below here, it's below the daily moving average. You're not going to be looking for buys. That's a simple trading system I wanted to share with you. I want to end with some tips. If you have any questions, comment below, guys. You know, reach out to me, go through my website. There's an email address. You can email me. You can trial the group. So I'll share with you. This is the link if you want to find out more about the course. You also get access to my live trading group where you can ask me questions. We can trade together to find out more about how we trade. And so with the course, you get access to 6 months of the Rockstar trading group if you're interested. So I'll leave the links below if you want to check us out. You get the full strategy, you know, about 20 hour long videos, and explains to you step by step risk management and all that good stuff. If you are interested, I'll leave the links below. But if you have any questions, comment below. I'll try to answer it. The first video in that trading strategy is about risk management, because if you don't have risk management, I showed you this trade setup. There's a couple of trades that would not have worked out. So if you don't have risk management and you go all in every trade, you're not going to make money in this market. So it's really important to have good risk management. So that's the first thing, you know, have stop loss, have targets, don't risk more than, you know, don't go 100x leverage. You know, it's really important to risk, you know, 2-3% up. Please demo practice and see if this strategy works. But when you do start using real money, please make sure you have risk management in place. You know, don't risk at all. Again, the first video in my trading course, I don't talk about buying support, buying resistance, you know, candlestick, crazy patterns, indicators, strategies. First few videos is all about just market psychology and risk management, because psychology is what, you know, people get fear. So I mean, I want to share with you another trade. You know, we bought the support. You know, this is a simple trading strategy, but another strategy, you know, this strategy will really help new people get involved in the market. But another strategy is buying the fear. When this sold off, we actually bought in the Rockstar trading group, bought another position, Bitcoin spot buy. You know, no one is buying there. Once it breaking down, people get scared, and I want to be buying when people are scared. And we got into profit within, you know, an hour. It went into, you know, 50, I think it went up almost 30-40% since the first dip. So, you know, just buying support, buying resistance is great. It's training your psychology to think differently to most people. So that's, it comes with practice. You really, really need to get involved and practice more. Another thing is learning Fibonacci. There's three videos I explain Fibonacci in a lot more detail. It's slightly beyond this video, but in simple terms, look for the 50% 618 pullback. A lot of the trade setups I'll share, you know, this is the hourly setup that I shared. The pullback usually happens around the 50% 618 zone. So keep that in mind. You can learn that. And these are some of the tips that I'm giving you. But the key thing is, you know, you might find out there's another tip, you know, maybe MACD, it gets bullish, or another indicator works, or you see a trend line break. You might be able to add things to these trading setups. But these four things are the key. I'm going to make more videos like this. Make sure you subscribe to the channel. But these four key elements that I'm sharing with you will really help you grow as a trader. And if we do get another crazy bull market, hopefully you can make generational wealth. But in the meantime, it can hopefully make you, you know, make some money in the weekly overall. And when Bitcoin gets those moves, you can really get in before people start getting bullish at resistance. You want to be buying support, selling resistance. And the key to it all is practice, practice, practice. Please practice yourself. You know, I've given the rules, go back to the charts, try to practice it. You know, you can then, after you've practiced on TradingView, again, check the links below. You can trade this on Binance or Bybit, BitMEX, those are a few ones that I use. Coinbase, even although their fees are high, they're the most reliable one. Then you can start putting, you know, $1,000 in, and then you can grow your wealth, you know, $10,000, $20,000, depending on how much money you have. So that's the video. Just to round up, the four key things I've shared with you is daily moving average, above 20 MA bullish, below 20 MA bearish, change RSI setting to 5, and we look to, you know, buy when it's oversold, and, you know, we look to sell when it's overbought. And then, guys, we look to buy at support and sell at resistance, and we look to buy. The probability of buys in an uptrend is more than, you know, in a downtrend, the probability of shorts is more. When the market is ranging again, and, you know, if we're trading against the trend, it's not as profitable. You know, when the market is trending up, like I showed earlier, here is a lot more difficult to trade. When the trend is up, it's a lot easier to trade. So thank you very much for watching this video, guys. You know, reach out to me on Twitter. I've been using Twitter platform a lot more, and YouTube as well. Again, I'm sure when cryptocurrency starts booming, we're going to have loads of people watching. But I'll carry on providing content, guys, whether it's, you know, I've started 3-4 years ago with 10 people, and I'll carry on providing content. Make sure you subscribe to the channel. I share exactly the levels I'm buying and selling. And thank you all, everyone, for support. People have been requesting this video for a while. Finally, I've had the chance to record it and get it out to you. So thank you all, guys. If you have enjoyed this video and want to find out more, I'll leave the links below for you to check out as well. Any questions, comment below on YouTube, reach out to me through email, on through the website, or, you know, on Twitter, or any other ways you want to reach out to me. I'll try and help you guys out. So thank you very much. Hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you guys soon with another great video. Thank you very much.